Umbraco Cloud uses Kudu as an open source engine behind Git deployments to Azure. Kudu provides both diagnostic information and the ability to extend the management environment. My name is Isha, and in this video, I'll give you a brief overview of how to use Kudu on Umbraco Cloud. So let's get started. I have a cloud project with three environments: development, staging, and live. Kudu is available for each environment on your Umbraco Cloud project. To access Kudu in any of your cloud environments, you will need to be an admin on your project. If I want to access Kudu on my development environment, I'll click on the small arrow next to the environment name, which will display the Power Tools option, also known as Kudu. Similarly, if you click on the arrows next to the staging or live environment, you can access Kudu for those environments respectively. Let's go ahead and access Kudu for the development environment. We are now prompted to log in using our cloud credentials. So let's add the credentials and click on sign in. We are now inside Kudu. Before we begin, there are a couple of things I want to mention. Firstly, I want to point out that Kudu adds .scm to your website URL. So, you can access this URL directly without going through the cloud portal. Secondly, you can use Kudu to view the files on your cloud environment, manually run extractions on your cloud environment, or generate UDA files for your project's metadata. And finally, some of the features and functionality in Kudu are not relevant to Umbraco Cloud. With this, let's get started. The homepage provides some basic information about the environment details, such as your site's uptime, site folder, temp folder, and some REST API endpoints, which you can use if you want to start building automated or remote tools to work with your installations. The environment section in the top navigation bar lists all the types of information you may need to know when running an application in an IIS environment, particularly if you're writing code to extend the application. Here, you'll find items like your system information, current app settings, connection strings, environment variables, path, HTTP headers, and server variables. Next up is the debug console. The debug console section is the section where you can view your cloud project files. Debug console provides a normal command line prompt and a PowerShell command prompt. You can use the PowerShell command prompt if you have developed specific PowerShell scripts for your site. In this case, I'll choose the command prompt. Umbraco Cloud doesn't have FTP access to your environment. However, from here, you can browse your file system either through the file browser or the command line. You might want to view the files you have on your Umbraco Cloud environment to make sure that everything is in sync, or if you suspect that deployment or extraction hasn't gone quite as planned. You can view your project files under the site folder. In this folder, the three most used folders are the deployments folder. This folder contains log files for the deployments and extractions that have been run on the environment. The second folder is the repository folder. This is your Git repository where the changes are pushed to and pulled from when working locally. And the third folder is the www root folder. This folder contains your site structure files. These are the files used to run the site in the environment. This is basically the root of your environment. As you can see, it also contains a standard Umbraco installation. This folder contains the files used to show your website to the world. When you push changes from your local machine, they are pushed to the Git repository, and after the changes are synced, they are copied to the live site here. If you wish to manually run extractions on your cloud environments or generate UDA files manually, you can navigate to the Umbraco folder and within it, the deploy folder, and run the echo deploy command. For more information, you can take a look at our documentation. I'll leave the link in the description box below. There are a couple of other options that you can do, such as downloading files and folders, viewing and editing text files, deleting a file or folder, or uploading files and folders using the drag and drop option. However, we do not recommend using Kudu for any of these actions. This should always be done via Git for deploying your local changes to cloud environments, and the deploy engine for deploying changes from one cloud environment to another. We recommend that you only use Kudu in such instances when it is explicitly mentioned in our document. The Process Explorer displays the currently running processes within your website resources. The Tools section has a bunch of useful and interesting tools. You can retrieve the diagnostic dump, which creates a zip archive of current log files and the event logs and downloads them instantly to your computer. View the web jobs dashboard if you're using web jobs, create webhooks to connect to third-party integrations, do a zip push deploy, download deployment script, and reach out to Kudu support. At the end, we have the site extensions page. Here, you can view the installed site extensions as well as browse from the gallery. If you've worked with Kudu before, you might have tried to install a bunch of site extensions from the gallery. You can do this on Umbraco Cloud as well. However, Umbraco doesn't really support it from here. You also have the possibility to restart your site. This is different from the restart environment option in the cloud portal. When you restart your environment from the cloud portal, it does a graceful shutdown of the application. But when you restart your site from Kudu, it forces the application to shut down. Therefore, we recommend using the Restart Environment option from the Cloud Portal and using this option as a last resort. And that's pretty much a brief overview of how to use Kudu on Umbraco Cloud. I hope you found this video useful. Thanks for watching. Until next time.